The next piece that you're going to hear is by our own Margaret Schedel, composition faculty here at SUNY Stony Brook. I'm going to ask Margaret to say a few words about her piece.
I'm just going to read the program note that I wrote because that seemed more logical than trying to talk about this extemporaneously. So the piece is called Kuhuka. I'll teach you how to say that later. And it takes its name from the interdimensional narrator of many of Italo Calvino's short stories, including the Cosmocomics, which describe the beginning of the world using both scientific hypotheses and cosmic language. Like the unknowable, unpronounceable Kuhuka, who has experienced all of time and space, this piece explores multiplicities of being, paradoxes, and contrasts. The piece is scored for two instruments, and the players read from a two-line score, and then they can choose to switch parts at the bar lines, which demarcate sections of varying lengths. The two lines have contrasting characters and are each treated to a different electronic manipulation that create multiple voices. The bottom line is lyrical, almost romantic in character, and the electronics create a Bulgarian chorusing effect through time, pitch, and timbre shifting. This chorusing effect can accrue up to 96 voices and is reset when the performers switch parts. The top line has an angular, disjunct, and modern character and also includes occasional percussive sounds. The electronics loop some of these percussive sounds, and by the end of the piece, this creates a third drum line. So in total, this single piece played by two instruments can ultimately evolve into as many as 99 possible lines, which can be in agreement or conflict depending on the musical performance. Only at the center of the piece do the two instrumentalists play the same melody in a weeping kind of fado-like passage that briefly unites the two voices before they diverge again. So thank you very much to Hearsay for asking me if I had a piece that they could play on this concert, and then they figured out all the transpositions to make this possible on marimba and cello, which is really cool. I never thought this piece could be played on these two instruments, and it works really well, and I'm so excited. So thank you.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.